earth to the sons of man.
And so now Jesus Christ said that we are the light of the world. Matthew chapter 5,
I think verse 7. He said we are the light of the world. He said we are the salt of the earth. Now salt means give taste. Let me start with the fact that Nigeria is the most religious nation in the world. Africa is the most religious continent in the world. But we are the poorest. We are the most horrible place. In fact, some people say that for you to give me black person blood, I will just be cutting it short because a lot of things to say. For you to, some white people prefer to die. And it was it Donald Trump and some people. They said, if I want to die, and they said, remove black person blood and put it in my blood, blood transfusion, that let me die. I don't want useless blood. I just don't want, next time we will be establishing some fact that it is there is confusion in the land. Jesus Christ is saying on one hand that you, that are my people, you are the light of the world. You are my people, you are the salt of the earth. You are my people, and he make a lot of promise. And then Obadiah chapter 23 said, saviors shall rise out of Zion. That word, another verse says, saviors shall rise out of church. Of course, you and I, except you want to be a joke, you know that it's slavery that rise out of Africa. If you go to America, I said, what used to rise up? That's why I said, heaven realities must correspond. And we will go ahead and see what is the light. But I will need try, we will see the meaning of light, because we may see the light of the world and we are thinking about another thing, maybe spirit. We will see whether the light of the world has to do anything with industrialization, development, because it is time through this church for Nigeria to be among the richest in the world. It is time through this church for Nigeria to be teaching all the other world how to live life that pleases God. That is the purpose of this church. But of course, you know, a poor person have no opinion. A poor person have no opinion. One Yoruba, they said that poor rich person is doing something anyhow. The poor person said, you will see. Kilo mari ju omi ekun elo, something like that. A parable goes like that. So the poor person have nothing to offer other than cry. It's the rich person that take over. So Nigerian have nothing to donate to Africa, have nothing to donate. But through this church, in the name of Jesus, things will begin to change.
Amen.
Because every reality will begin to correspond. Now, Jesus, God said, you are the light of the world. Let's go to the last development, because today is just an introduction. We don't want to, next time we'll be establishing. Deuteronomy chapter 28. That is just the last thing that I will say concerning those proofs that a new church needs to start. Deuteronomy chapter 28, you can read verse 1 if you are there. Deuteronomy 28, you can read verse 1.
And it shall come to pass.
And it shall come to pass.
And thou actively diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
Yes.
So observe and do all his commandments, which I have commanded thee this day, that the Lord thy God will set thee high above all nations of the earth.
Thank you very much. Now, Nigeria is the most religious nation in the world. Church plenty. In fact, the number of church that is Nigerian, in USA, that is also this, like the number of church is 3 times USA. Yet, we are paying tithe, we are doing everything, but that verse said, the Lord your God will set you high above all nations. That's why I said that place, I won't establish anything today. But I have just established that Nigeria is the poorest nation. In fact, check statistics. So something is wrong with the Christian in the ground, with the Christian. It is just normal. Just ask any Nigeria, enter bus, as you are going into bus, I do it very well. Just ask any Nigeria, church, forget about those people are business center. That is what I hear. I hear every time. Forget about those people, know Jesus Christ passed, nobody will record, nobody will feel anything. If Jesus Christ comes, they will drive him out of church, that go away with your principle. That is, if the truth comes, they will drive him away, that go out of your principle. Let's make money first. So, that is, and if you go and read the verse, that he said, you shall be above only. That Deuteronomy said, if you walk, remember, if you're walking unto the voice of the Lord your God, the Lord will put you above only and not beneath. That is what the word of God said. That if you follow God's word, he will set you above only. Now, check Nigeria. Check Nigeria. Okay, let's change that and go and begin to see something. A lot of churches, I just have 5 points to establish. A lot of churches today, but a lot of crime, raping, lying. Nigeria is the third most horrible place to live in the world because of crime. A lot of churches today, how many nations we have? 178 nations in the world. Nigeria is number three. Worst to live today. And Nigeria serve God the highest. So something is wrong with the message. Something is wrong with the delivery. Something is wrong somewhere. And this church is about to correct, because God will not set up new church until something is wrong and he wants to fix the thing. You understand? So let's go ahead and see everyone in the education know what can read. Okay, I was saying here that if everyone is educated in a land, they said that all of us here were educated, now give us book to read. Nobody can read and write. The thing does not, there is no truth here now. The thing does not correlate with reality. Nigeria is the most religious nation in the world, yet third most violent nation in the world. It does not correspond with reality. Most religious, third most violent. Something is wrong. Next time, on Thursday, if you come, or you follow us online, we will be checking. On Thursday, we will farabale, like Yoruba used to say, we will farabale, begin to check facts online. On Thursday, we'll be Google. We will use Google to prove that if somebody comes and says there is no church in Nigeria, the person is saying the truth. Because it does not correspond with reality. The question is, me that I am saying all these things, what give me evidence for me to say that church is supposed to develop Nigeria? Because God says so, Jesus Christ says so. Number two, early Protestant brought development to Europe. That is where religion started. Christianity started with Europe, go to USA, go to all those places. It brought tremendous development. Christianity stopped the killing of twins. Christianity stopped the cutting of people's head and bino. Christianity stopped all those things. Christianity stopped poverty. Christianity stopped to drive a woman out. So say, go and you are a winch because you give birth to two. Christianity stopped build house. Christianity start education, things like school. I'm talking about Protestant Christianity, the first Christianity that came. I am just giving evidence that something is wrong, but now we have already established it in God's word. Now we are just proving by early church. How does early church, maybe a little bit close to Jesus Christ, were doing? They build us for people. They send children to school free. Early church, stop horrible things like witchcraft. Let's burn this woman to death. Like all this kind of evil in the society, and so on and so forth. Anything that you can mention, killing somebody, burying 24 people with king in in this Ogun state. In this Ogun state, you go to maybe 200 years, not even 2,000 years ago, they were buried. If Oba died in this Ogun state, they buried king. They buried king with 24 virgin. Abi, how many is it? 12. Christianity came and stopped any social upheaval. But why is it that those social upheaval, all the wrong things continue to multiply, not only Christianity stopped? Africa was as developed as Europe. We were exchanging dollars to dollar. But why is it that dollars now, you must have 500 naira in Nigeria before it matches dollar? Something is wrong somewhere. This church would therefore have two missions. Number one mission is to preach the purpose, what God said. Number two mission is to correct the error. But we will not be pointing name, we will not be doing anything, because God that have sent me has shown me what is wrong. So let me give, for example, which class are you? Sit down very well. Which class are you? Primary what? Basic 3. If this boy, the guy that is doing basic 3, if we are teaching him multiplication table or additional table, if he does not know additional table, or he failed it, should we go ahead and begin to teach him multiplication table? We do the correction first. That is why this church, there is no way that we will not be pointing that this thing. We'll do the correction first before we take the pen, before we go to multiplication table. So we will correct something first, correct some things that our forefathers have done wrong, but we will not point them, we will not point anything.